The most important value is the relationship. The relationship between people in various social groups, which one belongs to. As you know, such culture is named collectivism. Yes, Japan is heavily under collectivism culture in its own way. Life is in a community. It starts at the birth and continues all the way through to the end of life. The ties are emotional, not functional. And ties are strong among the member of the same group. You are expected to adhere to the interest of the group, not your own. Group first, me later. This fact gives rise to a number of key notions that have shaped up Japanese culture. Yes, I said Japanese culture. Could you name some of these cultural features of Japan? I'm sure you heard of some cultural features of Japan which you are familiar with as a culture specialist. Could you type one or two words that characterizes the Japanese value set, the Japanese culture? Could you type it in now?
So we'll give that a second. There's some nice stuff. Cool. It's racing off the screen. Oh, it's going too fast for me. Everyone is going for it. This is great. You've obviously got the
really.
Loss of face and giving face. High power distance. Reverence for age and the elderly. A more masculine culture. Tatame. I don't know what that means, but I'm sure someone does. High context, harmony, two concepts of face, stoic, very interesting, humility, what else have we got? Sasuru, reliability and trust, change resistance, very interesting, kompai senpai, we've got some advanced students on the program here, past orientation, ensuring that you do not disturb anybody, doing your duty. Actually, maybe a couple more here. The middleman. Silence is important.
Interesting.
Uncertainty avoidance, perfectionism, aesthetic, risk averse, amikozo, wabi-sabi. Don't annoy other people. Mike, we have experts on the line. It's good.
Exactly. I'm very impressed. Wonderful. This was all describes some bits and pieces of Japanese value set. All right. But do you know that, if I may add, I would add the group interest first.
Yep.
Someone said silence. I think someone said harmony.
Yep.
And listen first, speak afterwards. These words which you gave me are based on a weak self, not a strong self. This doesn't mean that Japanese don't have self. They do. Their self resides in a way which is very different from the one in Europe and maybe North America. So I go on. You'll see more about how Japanese exist in the value set. Group work. The Japanese culture is heavily rooted in the rice-growing tradition. The Japanese grew rice for generations after generations. This tradition gave rise to a habit of living in a group and group mindset, rather than an independent mindset. You may be confused. So I give you some real examples. My grandmother was a farmer. She grew rice with people in the same village. Each farmhouse has its own rice field, but they worked. They helped each other. It's a very labor-intensive work. People share roles from growing to the harvesting of the rice throughout the year. For example, some people grow the young rice in the seed bed, others cultivate the land, some others are in charge of controlling the water supply in the early spring. And when the young rice is ready, all the villagers work together to bring the young rice to the rice field to plant the rice. And this kind of the co-work, coordination, working together habit continues through to the harvest. Village people also helped each other at every life event. Help at the birth of a baby, marriage, funeral, seasonal festivals at village shrines and temples. What does such tradition have to do with a modern business? It's a farmer's life. It has nothing to do with modern life. You may think in this way. Yes, there is a lot to do. Business in Japan is carried out in a group culture. In such an environment, your personality matters. You are supposed to know the roles you should take in the group without being told. Nothing's written. Just smell the air and look at what others are doing. You must be integrated in a group. Staying independent and unique is not good. These attitudes are regarded to be disturbing to the group. In a group culture, people don't think business is business. No, on the contrary, your behavior, your mindset, and your adherence to the group interests matter in doing business in Japan. Let me explain two major notions of Japanese culture. These are harmony, called wa, and silence, called chinmoku. What are they? I would explain wa in the form of ikebana. Please look at the photograph in front of you. The variety of flowers are nicely sorted, and they convey one message as a whole. What message would you read from the ikebana presentation in front of you? What message would you read? Could you type in the message you found in the flowers in the photograph? Could you type it in now and let me know? What message did you get?
Good, so we'll give them a couple of seconds. The first word has come in. Okay, here we go. Peace, nature is asymmetrical. Coordination, earth, humans, and heaven, creating space. None of the flowers are the star. It all works together. Balance. Everyone has his place and they will thrive. Each one makes the whole. Diversity, precision and control, purity at the front, boss at the back. Nice one, Olivia. One big and lots of small flowers.
Very interesting. Thank you very much. I'm sure you are a Japanese expert in Japanese culture. Someone noticed it's asymmetry. Someone noticed there are a variety of flowers. That is right. There are a variety of colors, variety of shapes, variety of height. Leaves are different in terms of color, in terms of the shape. And they, as a whole, they convey, they work as an entity. Everything is every flower piece is different, but they convey one unique message. The message, if I were to interpret, there's no right answer. All the answers are right. But the message I received as a Japanese who share the culture is the serenity and the beauty of the autumn. These are the flowers in the autumn. They are beautiful, but also serene. There are strong colors and weak colors, and they are arranged nicely so that they work in a harmony. If you see the process to create ikebana, you would be surprised. So many leaves and flowers and some twigs are cut off. It looks natural, but in order to express the nature of the flowers, the flowers are cut. The very artificial work is done behind the scene. It is very interesting.